Hello there, Ray here. We just finished watching the Minecraft live event for 2021, and there is a ton of new stuff we can look forward to with 1.19, the next new update in Minecraft. The new update is called Minecraft the Wild Update, and in this video, we're going to review not only what this update is going to bring us, but also other news that came out during the Minecraft live event. The first big news that they gave us is that the Warden in the Deep Dark is going to be pushed to 1.19. It's not going to be in the 1.18 Caves and Cliffs Update Part 2. This is something I anticipated and talked about in my previous video. And the reason behind this was because all the time it takes them to get the world to look nice with the new mountains, they had to not only make the new mountains, but they also had to make the rest of the terrain kind of flow nicely together. And they also worked on the whole higher worlds and the lower worlds, including the new caves. And this is just taking more time. Plus, on top of that, they also wanted to do a really good job of the Deep Dark, and they came out with so much new stuff that's going to go along with it. The next big thing they announced was the blending. So old worlds will still be able to update and not have these really jagged transitions from where the old terrain was to where the new higher terrain is at. But instead, they're going to keep track of like how much time you spent inside of a chunk. They will know that that chunk can kind of be tweaked so that it transitions better. The next big thing they announced is that Java as well as Bedrock are now going to have seeds that are almost exactly the same. So the parity between seeds for these two versions are going to allow players to use the same seed to let other people play on a similar world. They did say that they're not 100% the same, especially when it comes to like vegetation, but this is going to make it so that Java and Bedrock are becoming closer and closer together. So maybe someday we'll see full parity between the two of them. And the developers have said that this means that Bedrock is actually going to accept a lot of the different cool aspects that we have in Java. They also talk about when this next update is actually coming. They said in a month or two. So it's going to be around Thanksgiving time or Christmas time. So a period of time where most people will have some vacation days. The next big thing they announced was that the Xbox would get Game Pass for PC, letting people be able to play both Bedrock and Java editions on there. If you're enjoying the review so far, make sure you hit the like button. The next thing happened is that they did the mob voting between the Glare, the LA, and the Copper Golem. In the first voting session, they only keep the final two winners and the third one gets removed. And in this case, the LA was in first place, Golem was second place, and Glare was in third, and the Glare was removed. They then showcased a program called Blockbench, which allows you to easily make your own mobs in the game in Minecraft, and it works on all editions. They talked about how anybody can make mods in Minecraft. They then announced a new update for Minecraft Dungeon called Seasonal Adventures, and talked about some Halloween themes. They then did the second vote, where the LA was going against the Copper Golem, and the LA did win the vote with 54% and will be the next mod that's coming out. They said it will be coming out in 2022. And if you want to learn more about everything we currently know about the LA, check out this video here. They then announced the official name for the 1.19 update. It's going to be called Minecraft the Wild Update. They said it's going to include not only the wilderness update, but it's also include like nature, scary challenges, as well as adventures, which would include the Deep Dark and all everything else that comes with it, and new loot. They also showed us some of the new clips, such as the Deep Dark cities. Now in these cities, there's kind of a massive city, but in the center, there's kind of like a main structure that kind of incorporates everything else. You see there's candles, there's the new skulk blocks, as well as many of the blocks that we already have currently game, the new skulk growth. Also see the skulk sensors in use. We see some soul fire and soul lanterns in use. Some of the new blocks like the catalyst block, also the bloom block we see in this use, and also one called a screecher. There's some carpet here on the floor, and it looks like the majority of the structure is made out of the new deep slate blocks. There's some redstone lamps in there as well. The skulk growth kind of reminds you of the lichen. As you can see, it can be placed on all sides of the block, and it's a great way to bring more texture to the game by layering on top of other blocks like we do with the lichen. What cool things do you think might be in the Deep Dark? They then show how the new catalyst called the skulk catalyst block works. These are blocks that were leaked, but now we actually know how they function. Watch as this player kills this zombie. When the zombie dies, the XP falls on the ground, and where the mob dies, it actually reduces that new skulk growth and those new skulk blocks. Zombie dies there, player does get the XP, but it also causes the growth to appear right where it lands. And this is done by using a catalyst block. Player can break these using a hoe, and it doesn't drop an item, instead it drops the actual XP off of it, so you get more XP off of the same mob than just the initial stuff. And you can also see you can break the vine stuff. You can also use silk touch to acquire these as actual blocks rather than the XP. You see the vines don't actually produce anything, it's only the center blocks, and it looks like it converted the deep slate into those blocks, so we can have a way to actually farm these. Even though deep slate is currently a non-mineral resource, we can convert that into these skulk blocks. It also means that we can make an XP farm out of this by having mobs die near them and then mining up the blocks, and then they drop XPs. You can see that the player can actually acquire this catalyst block, so you can bring it to new areas, such as putting inside your farm. So I'll be curious to see if this can also cause growth to occur on other types of blocks, ones that are renewable, or if there's going to be a way to actually get renewable deep slate. So with the skulk growth, it is possible to kind of store XPs in these blocks and then mine them up. So we could make some type of XP farm using this. They made it seem that the mob can die by non-player means and still cause its growth. So that essentially means that players can get XP even if they're not there, which is pretty fascinating. Sort of like using a furnace to acquire XP for the player while it's in your spawn chunks. What cool things do you think we could do with this new feature? We don't know if the XP will come out even if you use like TNT or explosives to blow the blocks up. So that would be really interesting to see as well. I'm excited to design some cool farms using this mechanic. Make sure you guys have that subscribe button hit as well as turn on your bell so you don't miss out on those future contraption videos. Another new block that we now know the function is the Skulk Shrieker. This thing, when it gets activated by a skulk sensor, will then put off a shrieking noise.
Shrieker. So when this block is activated, it's gonna give that really scary shriek sound that you heard now. And it also gives this darkness effect, so it's like pulsating darkness.
So very unusual block, but it actually has a use in summoning the Warden. So here's it being used to summon the Warden. Obviously the Warden is more of a nuisance mob, and you really don't want to accidentally get it coming after you. But you open up the chest that activated the skulk sensor, which activated the shrieker, and then that is going to cause this noise, plus it's also going to cause that darkness effect upon the player. And you see there's another one over there. If a couple of these happen after a while, the warden is summoned. You can see some of the blocks look like they get removed, and then the warden is actually formed from those blocks. The blocks got replaced again. The player gets a darkness effect for about 25 seconds. You can see the warden actually is able to sniff the player. He's currently sniffing a player. Even though this player is crouching, he's still able to get close to him. And if the player accidentally actually walks on top of a skulk sensor, it will send it off even when you're crouching. The warden is sniffing out the player, and he's getting closer and closer, even though the player is being really quiet. Now that the warden is really close to the player, he is trying to actually home on in it. Player tries to distract him with a snowball. He comes over here, tries to hop down. He touches the skulk sensor, which activates the noise, letting the warden know where the player is at. Now he's coming after the player. You can see everything's really dark with the darkness effect. The warden comes in, corners him, and just two hits the player, doing about 6.5 damage with a single hit. We also know that the warden is really strong, as this player is wearing full netherite, and you can see he just gets two hit and killed. Now you can completely avoid the warden just by not making any noise, hear the player accidentally open up a chest. So keep that in mind if you're looting or breaking blocks. Also notice in the chest, the loot here currently looks like some snowballs, string, and some enchanted books. Also in this footage of the city, we can see there is a skeleton skull. But in the very beginning of the stream, it did say that stuff showed in the video might not be exactly how it's going to be in game. So the kind of the second part of the Wildy update includes actual wilderness kind of being brought into Minecraft. Here's one of their concept arts where it shows a birch forest. You can see there's a lot more life with like the little birch forest having like little nubs coming out of the trees. Obviously the big mushroom stools coming out of the side looks really cool. The plants are more in kind of like collection where like there's tall ones with little ones. And then there's like kind of bunches of flowers. There's also a laid over birch tree, which we don't have in Java, but Bedrock Edition do have these sort of things. The idea is just to bring more life to the game. And if we remember, Swamp was one of the biomes that didn't win in the past, but they said that all the biomes in the past, even the ones that didn't win, would eventually get updated. So this is the time for the swamp to get its revamp with the mangrove trees, the chest boats, as well as the frogs. But the main biome that they're going to focus on with the 1.19 Wildy update is the swamp biome. Here's some concept art where you can see it looks really cool. And they announced that this is going to come with boats with chest. So you're going to have the ability to place boats inside of chest. And then one player can ride it instead of two. You can hold your loot inside of it. It looks pretty cool. Probably going to be really used early game. Sick also be used because now all the rivers kind of connect with each other. But it also can be used down in the caves with the water aquifers. Although they're not as big and expansive as like the rivers are in the overworld. So it'll be interesting to see if this chest that's on the boat will have the same kind of collision as a boat. As you know, you can like stack boats. But will you be able to stack stuff on top of this chest? Or will it be just like other entities where they kind of get shoved through or shoved by when stacked? So part of this is going to be a new biome called the Mangrove Swamp Biome. This thing is crazy looking. You got the big, huge, kind of droopy trees. They also have these hanging things, which are like the tree's saplings. And these mangrove trees can actually be grown from the propagule, which are these kind of limbs that come down off of the tree and eventually can produce new trees and fall off, and it can even travel really far. And then once they do set root either in water or even on land, these are kind of like the saplings. They can grow up into a tree. And these trees are unique where they have a new type of wood. You can also see some leaves, vines hanging from them, plus some new type of root blocks down here. And you can see the propagule hanging off of the trees trying to go downward. So I'll be curious if the leaves actually drop saplings, or we have to collect these off of the tree in order to grow more of them. And hopefully they can be acquired without needing the player to mine them, because then you could collect these using like piston and then replant them to produce more of these crazy looking trees. They also showed us what the new wood type is going to look like. It looks kind of like jungle wood type and acacia kind of mixed together. The texture of the log is kind of a deeper browner color than we've had in other versions of trees. To me, it looks very similar to the other blocks. Let me know what you guys think about this. The ends of the log look kind of similar to like the jungle ones, but people are always looking for a new wood type. We didn't get one for the azalea tree, so it's cool that we got one for the mangrove tree. And overall, they want the tree to kind of make these really big root clusters where the player can actually swim their boat underneath them. So you can see that in the actual showcase of the biome here, where they have the really tall root blocks holding up the center of the tree. They might also notice that these new blocks that are around the trees are not anything we have currently in the game. The biome itself is look like it's going to be separate from a swamp biome, kind of similar to how a bamboo jungle is separate from a jungle. And those new blocks that we've seen are actually can be crafted by using a water bottle onto a dirt block, and this is going to convert it into the new mud block. So the mud block is renewable, and hopefully they let us do this using like dispensers. Kind of like how we can use bottles with dispensers to pick it up and produce water bottles. Hopefully we can use dispensers with water bottles onto dirt blocks in front and convert them into the new mud block. Now dirt is renewable. If you've guys seen my infinitely automatic dirt block farm, I'll have a link below. But then using that, you can then convert it into mud. They also show that we can now get renewable clay in the game without using villagers. This is done by having a mud block on top of one of the dripstone. It kind of like dries it out and turns it into clay. So after we convert it into mud, then we can push it over top of one of these dripstone, and then they can dry it out. Then we can push this into a blast chamber and have it broken down into an item. Really cool way. I'm so excited to make new farms using this. With the mud blocks, you can actually make mud bricks, which they show here. It looks really cool. I actually like this one. Some of them don't turn out so nice, but the mud bricks really look nice in the game. Hopefully they also come out with a wall as well as the stair variation. They said they came out with the mud bricks for people that actually live in houses that are constructed out of mud bricks, be able to actually build their own houses, which is really cool. And they came out with the new frogs. These things look crazy. They kind of look like between a frog and a toad. Kind of very bulky-like. They like to hop around randomly. They're quite derpy, and they're also quite cute. And you can see they sometimes hop forward, and sometimes they also hop backwards. But with the frogs comes fireflies, which are these kind of little teeny small creatures. I think they might be like particles. I don't know if these will be actual entities, but there's a whole bunch of them. And they hover around just like fireflies do in real life, or lightning flies. And the frogs will actually try to eat these things. And they do kind of put off this kind of blinking glowingness. Once again, trying to bring more life into the game by fleshing out the current biomes that we had. Something the developers talked about in the past. And it really fits in with the wild update. And unlike other mobs that have babies, the babies are usually just half-sized versions of the adults. Baby frogs are actually tadpoles. And they came out with baby tadpoles, which is little guys that swim around in the water. They say you can pick these things up and move them about, and they'll eventually grow into big frogs. But the big frogs that they actually grow into is based off of the temperature of the biome. Here you can see a normal tadpole that was placed into a cold biome turn into the cold variation of the frog, which is this dark green one. So this is really cool where they're adding the new temperature thing into the game to determine how a mob is going to look in a biome. We kind of had this with villagers, but this is actually taking temperature and not necessarily a specific biome. So there's three types in total. We looked at the swamp type, we also looked at the cold type, and there's also a tropic type. These tropic types will actually come and turn to a whitish gray frog. And this was supposed to let them kind of let a lot of the sunlight that comes from the tropics kind of reflect off them so they don't overheat. But it's kind of cool to see the frogs in the desert as well. So it'll be interesting to see which biomes these actually spawn in. Will they kind of spawn in all biomes? Because technically the cold, the tropic, and the humid are all temperatures that are in other biomes. Will the tadpoles be attacked by other things like the axolotl, where the frog meat attack other things like axolotl. In real life, a lot of things do eat frogs, so I'd be curious to see how they spawn and how they interact with the world. Will killing the frogs drop something like frog legs, which can be used to make like leaping potions, or will they drop like nothing? More recently, Mojang has been making it so mobs don't drop anything to try to discourage players from killing mobs. They also mentioned that the frogs are going to have special abilities that can help the players. Listen to Agnes talk about this.
Different color variations, but you also have something else special about the frogs.
Yes, so each frog variant is going to have something unique that will be useful for the players. But we actually don't even know what that is yet because we are working on the frogs right now.
So that's really fascinating to think that frogs are actually going to be somewhat useful. Sometimes you see where mobs get added into the game, such as like the polar bear, and nothing really much comes of it. So maybe the frogs will give you like a leaping effect when you're near them, kind of like a dolphin gives you a special effect. What abilities do you think this frog could somehow give to a player to help him out? So the wild update is going to encompass bringing more atmosphere and beauty to the already cool biomes that we have in the game, as well as the deep dark and the mysteries behind the ancient cities, which we really don't know why they're there or how they got there. Like a lot of things in the game, Minecraft brings a lot of lore to the game. With these new blocks, it means we got more blocks to add to my document where I'm trying to make a farm for every item in the game, Minecraft. If you'd like to see the progress we have currently on that, check out the link down in the description. And if you'd like to see all the current changes for 1.18, check out this playlist over here. I hope you guys enjoyed this review and stay tuned for more 1.19 updates. And big thanks to everybody who joined my live stream of us discussing this Minecraft event. I'd like to thank all you guys for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.